Hey, Planty friends. I'm back. It's been a while. I'm sorry. I took some time off from making YouTube videos. I had promised you guys a video every other week, and then I did like 3 videos in 1 week, and then I disappeared for a whole month. My cat's trying to come into the camera. What are you doing? I'm trying to record a video now, baby. Can you tell them your name? Oh, his name is Squeakers. What would you like to tell everyone? Oh, is that right? You want to be snuggled? Right now? Right now while I make this video, you want to be snuggled? That's a drool on your forehead. You think we can do the video like this? Yeah, I didn't think so. Okay, well, the cat snuggle session kind of interrupted things. Let me just tell you how things are going. Right now, behind my camera, it's a hot mess. I took some time off because, one, I've told some of you before, I'm in graduate school, and that's not fun. Don't do that. If they told you to go to graduate school, don't. That's all. That's my advice. I'm just kidding. No, it's really worth it, and I'll get a job at the end of it, right? So between school, doing work, I'm doing a practicum, I work 2 jobs, and I'm doing all working from home, so you'd think I have time at home to record videos. But I don't. I actually have time to take care of my plants and look at all my plants and take care of these amazing cats all day long. But yeah, it's been hard to figure out time to when I can record videos. And one thing that I keep trying to remember when I think about recording a video, I think of what my boyfriend asked me one day while I was recording a previous video. I was walking back and forth doing the video, and he goes, "Are you stressed out at all, or are you enjoying this?" And during that video, I was enjoying it. So excited, it was so hype. I've tried to keep that in the back of my mind when getting ready to like record a video. I think about, will this stress me out? What is my stress level at this point? And it's been really high lately, so I just decided not to record videos. I thought that it would, you know, impact my mental health, and I love my plants, and I don't want to not love my plants, you know what I mean? So during the time that I've been away, I have tried to create a brand for myself, and that has been really enjoyable, and that just took up some of the time that I could have been recording as well. So I created a name that is not my personal name, and you might have already seen that now that you're here on YouTube watching my video. You might see that here, but check this out. Well, there you have it. I created that fun little intro, so I hope that that will also keep my videos a little bit more engaging by putting that fun little video with my name at the beginning. I'm like super professional. And so that's kind of what I've been doing mostly, has been just going into that. Squeakers, you can't lay on my notes because then I won't know what to talk about. Thank you. Oh, I didn't get any water. Let me get some water. So yeah, that's gonna be my fun new video. I hope you guys like the name. I hope you guys like the branding idea that I'm going with. I have told you before, I live near the Rocky Mountains. I'm a mountain girl. I love to be outside. I love hiking. So I kind of wanted to incorporate that. It was either create a name involving the mountains or create a name involving cats. This video, I kind of want to do just like vlog-ish style video, and just I'm sitting down trying to just be a little relaxed, not trying to be hype about anything in particular. I have a bunch of updates and I just wanted to kind of update you guys on everything that I want to be doing with this YouTube channel specifically. We're in a day and age where everyone is like TikTok videos and Instagram reels, and that is beyond me. I am too old for that. You know, I don't look like it. Moisturizer. But I am a little older and I don't feel like the TikTok stuff is for me. I really want to do the vlog style videos, and I like Instagram to post quick updates. It doesn't involve editing, so I really like to be able to post things on there. So I created an Instagram account. You'll see the name here, or here, or here, or here, 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 maybe even here. Maybe I'll post it right here. Who knows? But you'll see it pop up on the screen. Go to my Instagram. Some of you might follow my personal Instagram account, and I have unfollowed you there and have just followed you on the Plantygram at this point, because it's just gonna be easier for me to manage the two separate things. I wanna have one that's personal, that I don't have to worry about like random people messaging me and random people sending me, you know, requests. I can kind of mitigate that a little bit more. And for the Plantygram page, you can see that I will just add anyone. That makes it easier for me to share stories and tag people so people can see some stuff, especially some of the brands that I'm gonna be like investing in. I wanna be able to tag them and I want them to be able to see that. So that was another reason why I created the Instagram, and kind of why I wanted to create a name too, is to do an Instagram, really, just so I can have that as another platform. So those are gonna be my only forms of content here on YouTube and on Instagram. So some plant updates. As you can see, I've got this cute stand here. I've kind of redid this corner just a little bit. This was a stand that was on the patio. I brought it inside, put my Christmas cactus on here. There are some blooms happening. There was a really pretty one here the other day, and there's some blooms coming up there because it is October, so Christmas cactus, Thanksgiving cactus, whatever you want to call it. I've got some basil here. This is some fresh basil that just grew in this one pot. I think he's starting to flower actually on the tip there. So you need to like save everything, dry it out, just create some seasoning. My intention was not to give you like a full update on videos, but I saw this Hoya just a second ago. Look at those two pink leaves. She's got all these white leaves on this side. And I recently learned with Hoyas, when they put out new leaves, it's called throwing hands. That's fun. I like that. So she's throwing hands all over the place. So she's got new leaves popping out all over the place. No peduncles for flowers. And I'm assuming that I probably won't see that for another year, I'm assuming, because I don't think that they blossom during the winter. So I'm assuming they would only blossom in like the spring and the summer. So hold on to your seats, folks. We'll see what happens. One big update, you can kind of see right here. I got a humidifier, friends. So here it is. I'm just holding my tripod right now. You can see this is the Elk Homes humidifier. If you are on into the plant thing, you probably see this humidifier everywhere. It is awesome. It's a top fill humidifier. Sorry, I'm trying to stabilize this a little bit, but these little things here like move to different directions. There's two of them here. It comes with a remote. You can keep track of the humidity. So it's at, I have it set to 90% humidity, and it's at 89% humidity. So once it hits 90% humidity, you'll see it just turn off. I have it on the highest setting of humidity. And then this little sign here stands for heat. So I have the heating element turned up to just 1. I don't want it too hot and humid, so I'm just doing it lightly.
The reason why it says it's 90% humidity is because it's just beating up against this Raphidophora tetrasperma right now. It's popping out a new leaf, so I want to try to give it as much humidity as I can to help unfurl that leaf. And that's why, so it's like, it says it's 90% humidity, like, right here. My whole apartment right now is only at 24% humidity, so this is just in this area. I have my Venus flytrap sitting up here because he was not looking happy. You can see a lot of those leaves were like getting crispy and dying, but I put him over here by the humidifier and it's popping out this new little leaf here that's going to be beautiful, and it's popping out a whole new little patch there in the center. So I think they go dormant in the winter, but we'll see what we can do if we can keep him going throughout the winter.
So yeah, that is another cool update, the humidifier. I want to work on trying to get, like, my alocasia, I really want the humidity.
My spider plant up here, who is doing so well since I repotted him a couple months ago, when your spider plant's tips get crispy, that means, I mean, they don't need humidity, spider plants, but they do like humidity. So by putting the humidifier here, I'm hoping that it'll help with some of the crispy tips on the spider plant. Not too worried about it, but I don't have a whole lot of plants that are like dying for humidity, but I'm excited to then purchase some Calathea and some Marantas because I know that they really need the humidity. So I'd really like to incorporate a shelf of some sort here with the humidifier with a bunch of really humidity loving plants. So that's really why I got it, so I can like really, I've been doing research on plants. Plant tip, do research on plants before you buy them so you don't kill them. So I'm hoping that I can purchase a Maranta, a prayer plant, or some Calathea and keep the humidity up for them so they can thrive and be happy. Since the last time I saw you, I also have had two plants die. My orchid bit the dust. Thing I learned there, don't repot your orchids. If you bought your orchids from the grocery store, keep them in the container that they were in forever. Never pull them out, ever, unless you're feeling ballsy. I bought sphagnum moss and orchid bark and everything, and I repotted it and it just died right away. So, oh well, I'm not a big fan of orchids. They're beautiful when they're blooming, but once they bloom and they die, it takes forever to even try to get it to bloom again. I also had my alocasia poly that I don't know if I featured in a video in here. Maybe I did in my plant tour. I think I featured him in the plant tour. Posted a lot about him on my Instagram, on my other Instagram, my personal Instagram account. I was curious, he's dropping the leaves. Why is he dropping leaves? I don't know. So I was really frustrated. It kept dropping leaves. A lot of people say that they go dormant, alocasia. They go dormant in the winter. I find hard to believe, but maybe they do, I don't know. So here he is, the last dead leaf, and he's like very much attached to the bulb, and there was some new, all the roots had died, they had root rot, all the roots fell off, but there's like new growth points on there. I watched some videos and everything is like, just keep it in the dirt, let it dry out, put it in a dark place, water it when the spring comes around and it'll start rooting again and it'll start putting out new flowers. So that's my goal. I think I let him dry out, but I'm gonna stuff him back in the pot in the dirt that he was in, and then I'm gonna just stuff him into the closet out on the patio and bring him out in the spring and see what happens. I really like alocasia poly. They're so beautiful, and they have them right now at the grocery store because they're like Halloween themed. And they're like $28, which I spent $20 on this plant. And so it's like, do I go buy another one or is it just gonna die? I've been watching the ones at the grocery store for about a month and they've somehow kept them alive at the grocery store. So I don't know, maybe those are better, but I just don't know if I wanna spend the money on it right now. So I really wanna be an alocasia girl. That's what I want in life, is to just have all the alocasias. That's wishful thinking, I think. Another fun update that I have that I'm going to do, which is going to give me a lot of content to give to you guys and a lot of stuff to keep you updated on Instagram. I am going to start planting house plants from seed. I first and foremost want to throw out a shout out to Morgan's House Plants because she is the one who posted on her Instagram that she is growing some plants from seeds. And I was like, excuse me, what? You can grow plants from seed. I am a gardener. I do outdoor gardening every year and we plant a lot of stuff from seed. So I really like starting things from seeds, tomato plants, I mean my basil, lavender, pepper plants, squash, zucchini, beans, peas, all of it. Like I do a lot of that from seed. Sometimes it's just easier to buy a tomato plant from the Home Depot and put it in the ground, but whatever. Well, I was really excited at the idea of getting seeds and starting some of these houseplants. And some of these seeds are some houseplants that I have on my wish list, but I know that I could either never afford or I just don't have the space for right now. And so I'm really excited to do this for you guys. Are you ready? Okay, so the name of the company is called Plant Flix. These are the ones that Morgan had on her Instagram that she posted videos about. Go follow Morgan on YouTube and on Instagram. She has the cutest little pup and she's got a great plant collection, and she's also a metalhead, and I'm a metalhead in my heart. That was my high school years. Not anymore, but saw Slayer twice, so feeling pretty connected with Morgan. So Plant Flix, I ordered a whole bunch of seeds from them, and you guys are gonna lose it when you see the names of the plants that I have right now that I'm about to grow. You're gonna lose it. First of all, we have the Philodendron Hope seed. You can see by the picture there. Which is a philodendron split leaf. You've seen them, they get really, 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 really big. I'm sure I'll have it and it'll be tiny forever before I actually get it going. Next, we have a polka dot plant, which I didn't realize I ordered the polka dot plant one. So that's exciting. Tropical pitcher plant, which is another carnivorous plant, just like my Venus flytrap. And it grows the little pitchers off the side of the plant. And it's a little cup, it's like a little pitcher, and then it like catches bugs and stuff inside of it. So this one's gonna be tricky because I am in a very arid, dry climate and this is gonna need a lot of humidity. It's probably gonna take a few years before it even like develops a pitcher. So this one's exciting. The big one that I'm really excited about, I hope you're ready for this. Look at that. This is Monstera deliciosa. Seeds from a seed. Oh, I am so excited. So I just opened it up. That's what those Monstera seeds look like. How cool, right? So there's 10 seeds in this pack. So that's what the number is on there, is like how many seeds are per pack. So that's exciting. And then another one that I got that I'm also excited about, because I saw them once on heart-shaped leaves. She showed one of that, this, she had this plant. It was like the only way that she would get this plant is if it was variegated. And I was like, I've never even seen a variegated plant like that. But it is African violet. So these are African violet seeds and they came in this cute little tin. There's 20 seeds in here. The instructions were very specific that when I open this container to be very careful because the seeds are tiny. They're like microscopic. They're so like a tinier than a grain of sand. So I'm excited for this and nervous for this. So if you don't know what an African violet looks like, I brought my African violet here to show you. So they have beautiful flowers that come out of them, but when I bought this, it had purple flowers. And it hasn't had flowers since then. And I don't know if it ever will have flowers again, but there's a lot of new growth in there, if my cat will let you see it. So cool, the leaves are kind of furry. There's some hair, you can see the hair. I think the camera's catching it too, you can see that. Not the cat hair, squeakers. The variegated one is just gonna cause these leaves to become variegated. You wanna see? Do you wanna see the plant? So I'm very excited to bring you that addition to the plant channel. And to Instagram, I'm gonna keep you updated. It's gonna be a fun thing to do over the winter to kind of get that set up and see what it looks like in the springtime. So hopefully I can get them kind of growing into seedlings and then see what happens in the spring. From here, what does this mean? Video content. I gotta come up with some good content. I really wanna do a series of top five favorites. So I'd like to do a series for that. So if you guys have any suggestions on doing
top 5 things you would like to see, let me know. My next video, I really want to do a watering video because I've been really trying to figure out how to use a moisture meter and seeing how accurate that is. So I've been really playing around with that for a month. I wanted to work on it first and understand how it works before I provided you any information. So I'd like to do a watering video for you guys to show you how I tap water, bottom water, use the moisture meter on some of my plants. So that's gonna be another video. I really want to start a propagation box. So some of you might have seen that around, throwing some sphag moss in a Tupperware container, throwing some cuttings of some leaves and some plants, throwing it in there and watch them grow, see what you get out of it. I need some more plants that I can propagate to do that from. So I need to maybe purchase some more plants before I can do that. Or if you're local here and you know where I'm at and you know me personally and you have some plants that you would love to give me trimmings of so I can propagate them, please feel free to donate to me. Help me. I'm poor. So if you have any plant video suggestions, some things you'd like to see, some material that I could provide to you guys, let me know. I have also learned that I am not going to be able to do a lot of unboxing videos because I cannot afford plants. They are very expensive. The prices of houseplants have skyrocketed. I bought seeds of Monstera to grow from seed because it was cheaper to do that than it is to buy a Monstera plant. I guarantee it's gonna be 4 years before I see a leaf on that thing that has any fenestration, but that's cheaper for me than it, and more of an experience for me than it is to just go buy the plant. I just don't think that I can afford to buy plants. And I listened to another YouTuber recently who had said something about just because you want it doesn't mean you can have it. You can buy any houseplant online right now. And you know, I'm trying to support my local plant shop right now. There's a couple of them here in town and I want to support them. So if they get a plant that I look at, that I want for my wish list plant list and they have it, I'd rather support them than being like, I want an alocasia black velvet and I'm gonna order it online, because that kind of just defeats the purpose for me. Like kind of the same way with another hobby that I have, I collect vinyl records, and I started that like 15 years ago. I started it a long time ago. My thing was to never just go out and buy the vinyl record that I want brand new. Like I had to either thrift it, have it gifted from somebody, or find it in like a situation, because it makes for a better story, right? It makes for a better experience when you're listening to that vinyl record to be like, oh, my so-and-so friend gave me this, or I found this at a thrift shop when I was shopping with this friend that one day. Like, it just makes for a better experience. And so that's kind of what I'm going for with my plants. I think that all plants should have a story and not just I went to the store and picked it up and bought it. So I want to really create stories for my houseplants and not just bragging rights. And I know there are some people out there agree with me with that. And I know that there's some people out there that have the money that can go out and just purchase plants and buy all the plants they want. And that's fantastic. You know, do you, boo. Do what makes you happy. For me personally, I want to get plants and I want them to all have a story. And I want to grow them from seed and have an experience. What do you think, Jim? You a good boy? What is it? It's been a busy day with these cats. They've been all up in the video. Maybe they're truly the YouTube stars here, not me. All right, planty friends. Thanks for sticking around for watching this. I really appreciate your support. Sorry I was MIA for a while. A lot of stuff going on in my life, but I'm feeling like I have a better grasp on what I'm going to be doing now that I have a new name. So just follow me on my Instagram. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel to support me, and let's make things happen, friends. See ya.